Coral reefs are incredibly important ecosystems. Remarkably, they only take up less than 1% of the total ocean area, but they actually are responsible for more than 25% of the biodiversity of the world's oceans.
When we think about coral reefs, we think about the full ecosystem. And by that, I mean not just the fish and the species that you find on a reef, the seagrasses, the mangroves adjacent, but the communities that live there.
Coral reefs around the world, there's about a billion people, at least about a billion people today, that are dependent on coral reefs for their livelihood. Climate change, we're talking a lot about that, but the reality is that change is already there today. People are changing and having to change their practices right now.
Ocean warming is causing rapid and continuous coral bleaching. There's also some critical local threats. The most significant is declining water quality and also unsustainable fishing practices.
You know, these threats are all happening at the same time, and it's just making it really challenging for coral reefs to recover on their own.
The greatest challenge facing reefs today is the threats feel too big and there's not enough hope. The global community has coalesced around ocean conservation in a way that's never been seen before. There is hope because there is momentum, there are passionate, engaged actors, and there are solutions.
I think what's really innovative about the Resilient Reefs Initiative is that it takes a systems approach. It understands that if we have healthy reefs, we also need to have healthy communities. What has been wonderful and essential is the importance of indigenous communities, local communities, leading solutions in their backyards.
The idea behind it has always been to put people at the very center of the decision making. And those strategies have been put together from the bottom up with all the different stakeholders. But the success about it is that they also are carried forward and supported by the government entities that can take it forward now and actually implement that.
We worked in 4 UNESCO World Heritage sites. We worked on the Ningaloo Coast in Western Australia, the Belize Barrier Reef, we worked in the Rock Islands in Palau, and we worked in New Caledonia as well.
It's a very innovative, very broad initiative. You're not just talking about reef ecosystem, you're also talking about the community and the governance. This holistic approach can also be threatening people who are resistant to change. And now we see managers using some of the tools that we provided with Resilient Reefs or are trying to think how to embed it into the new management plan. So we're seeing change. It takes time, but we're seeing it.
The Resilient Reefs Initiative in Belize has identified some key flagship actions. These actions can help our management interventions to be more enduring over a longer period of time, but also to serve current needs and challenges facing our reefs.
Resilience is moving away from traditional management strategies which assume a stable system into a comfortableness with uncertainty and proactively managing for change. So it's a whole lot of management agencies, tourism operators, community members, traditional owners, all working together and contributing their own knowledge and contributing their own experience and capacity to plan and manage together.
Coming from Palau, we are known to be children of the land and the ocean. And to be resilient, we have to understand that the conditions of our resources will change. But what we can do is to be open for opportunities like Resilient Reef in order to adapt. And that is what this initiative has begun in my community.
In terms of what Resilient Reefs has achieved in the first phase, we've had more than 2,000 local beneficiaries that have been involved in the projects. We funded more than 20 on-ground projects, and so they are delivering really strong outcomes to build not only reef resilience, but also community resilience. And also, we've created a knowledge network that is really trying to rapidly share the learnings around the world, because we know that our window to act is rapidly closing. We need to share that really quickly so that others can be on the front foot in the face of the crisis that coral reefs are up against.
I think we have to remember that they support 1/4 of all marine life. And if you think about what happens when you lose a reef, you're losing all of those services and benefits that that system provides. We lose 1/4 of our oceans.
If reefs go away, people on this planet who live in treasured coastal communities, their livelihoods are threatened, their way of life is threatened, and we've got to do something about that.